This is part 18 of Roots and Radicals. And in this video, I'm going to go over how to rationalize denominators still, but we'll be working with something a little bit different. Problems that look like this. 1 over 3 minus square root of 2, for instance, where as opposed to having just a square root of 2 in the denominator or a 3 square roots of 2, I have a binomial. So when we had a problem like this, 1 over 3 square roots of 2, I was able to simplify that by multiplying the top and bottom by square root of 2. And then in the denominator, I would have 3 times 2, or 6, and that's a way of rationalizing the denominator. So multiplying by the irrational number itself, square root of 2, I was able to get a rational number in the denominator, 6. Now, that doesn't work in the top. You might think it does, but let's just go ahead and try it. What if you multiply the top and bottom by square root of 2? Then in the numerator here, I would get square root of 2. And what happens in the denominator? I've got the distributive property. So I've got to do square root of 2 times 3, which is 3 times the square root of 2, minus, and then I've got square root of 2 times square root of 2, well, that's 2. And you can't cancel, by the way, these square roots of 2s. You can only cancel if that's a factor. And 3 square roots of 2 minus 2 is some big old number. You don't know what it is. It's not just square root of 2 by itself. So whereas we started off with 1 over 3 minus square root of 2, we actually made a bigger mess. And now we have that's equivalent to square root of 2 over 3 square roots of 2 minus 2. So that little trick of multiplying by square root of 2 over square root of 2 did not work in this problem. All right, before going on what is going to work, let's write down some problems. How about 5 plus square roots of 7 times 5 minus square roots of 7? And let's do 3 square roots of 2 minus 4 times 3 square roots of 2 plus 4. And let's do square root of 7 minus square root of 2 times square root of 7 plus square root of 2. All right, I want you to go ahead and multiply these out. You've done these before when we were just doing multiplication with binomials. It's just that you've got some square roots here. And see what you get. Okay, for the first one. Did you notice this is at the form a plus b times a minus b? If you do the FOIL method, the outer and inner terms will be opposites. So I ended up with just 5 times 5, which is 25, minus square root of 7 times square root of 7. That's what you should have ended up with. Because your middle term, one is a negative 5 square root of 7, one is a plus 5 square root of 7, will cancel. So this actually ends up being 18. So when you multiply 5 plus square root of 7 times 5 minus square root of 7, you get a rational number 18. All right, it's the next one. Same thing. The outer and inner terms are going to be opposites because the only difference between the first and the second binomial is one has a plus sign and one has a minus sign. So I have 3 square roots of 2 times 3 square roots of 2. So that's going to be 9 times 2 minus the last term, 4 times 4 is 16. So I get 18 minus 16, which is 2. Okay, let's do the last one. All right, so again, if you do first, outer, inner, last, the outer term is going to be plus square root of 14. The inner term will be minus the square root of 14. So those are going to cancel. So I'm going to end up with the square root of 7 times square root of 7, which is 7, minus square root of 2 times square root of 2, which is 2, which is 5. All right, what was special about each of these multiplications? These were all in the form a plus b times a minus b, which was a squared minus b squared. So if any of those happen to have a square root in them, when you squared it, you ended up getting rid of the square root. And that's what really happened in all three of these problems. And you ended up with what? A rational number. No square roots at all. Okay, as it turns out, a plus b and a minus b are called conjugates of each other. So 5 plus square root of 7 and 5 minus square root of 7 are called conjugates. 3 square roots of 2 minus 4 and 3 square roots of 2 plus 4 are called conjugates. Okay? So a minus b and a plus b are called conjugates. And what happens when you multiply conjugates of each other that have square roots is you end up getting ra a rational number. So we would say the conjugate of 2 minus square root of 7 is, what would the conjugate of 2 minus square root of 7 be? 2 plus square root of 7. Okay? So now let's look back at our original problem. We had 1 over 3 minus square root of 2. So the trick is, what can I multiply that by so that I'm going to get a rational number in the denominator? And the answer is multiply by its conjugate. So we're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of 3 minus square roots of 2. All right, so what's the conjugate of 3 minus square roots of 2? 3 plus square roots of 2. All right, so in the numerator, I have 1 times 3 plus square roots of 2, which is just 3 plus square roots of 2. And what happens in the denominator? These are conjugates, so it's really just a squared minus b squared. So it's really just 3 times 3, which is 9, minus square root of 2 times square root of 2, which is 2. And that's our answer. 3 plus square root of 2 over 7. So that's the trick. If you have a binomial with the square root in the denominator, it's not really a binomial in a certain sense because there's no variable, but it looks like a binomial, doesn't it? It's got a minus sign there. All right, let's look at some more problems. So let's say we've got 5 over square root 11 minus 2 square roots of 2. So I need to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate. All right, so in the denominator, I had squared 11 minus 2 square roots of 2. What is the conjugate going to be? Squared 11 plus 2 square roots of 2. Okay, let's do the denominator first. Later, I'll explain why I do the denominator first. So this is going to be a squared minus b squared. So squared 11 times squared 11 is 11. So the denominator I know is going to be at the bottom. 11 minus, now 2 square roots of 2 times 2 square roots of 2, that's going to be 4 times 2, or 8. So I'm going to get a 3 in the denominator. Now the reason I do the denominator first is I look back up to see if that might cancel with what's in the numerator. And if it doesn't cancel, then I'm going to go ahead and do the distributive property. So that's where I am right now. I'm going to do the distributive property in the numerator. So I have 5 square roots of 11 plus 5 times 2 square roots of 2 is 10 square roots of 2. And that is your answer. Okay. So that's the trick. We're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of whatever's in the denominator. And we're going to do some more problems on the next video.